I was brought up in Scarborough on the east coast of Yorkshire. There are no musical conservatoires there, and I was largely self-taught. My love of the moors helped me in this. Up there, I could test my ear on the natural sounds around me and jot down the notes in a little book. I could make out the overtones of the waves ebbing and flowing on the shore. I was fascinated by the sounds of the seagulls, the rising thirds of their calls differing as they glided past. It was because of this wonderful inner ear that I was about to give up my life at Scarborough and leave home. Tomorrow I would be leaving for France. I was about to embark on a great adventure, which was to change my entire life. This was the first time I'd been out of England. I was now looking at the French countryside on my way to Bouron, a tiny village station about an hour's run beyond Paris. Delius, I presume?
Mr. Fenby, this is a pleasure. I am delighted that you have come out here to help my husband. We both appreciate your kindness very much. If only you can work together in some way, it will be so good for him. Better than all the medicines in the world. It is the dream of my life that he will be able to compose again. André, le bagage de monsieur.
How is Mr. Delius?
Delius is fairly well. He is still resting. He will be brought down for the evening meal. You will meet him then. You do play the piano?
Oh, yes.
Here we are. We've lived here for over 30 years. This is the music room, where Delius has written all his finest music.
Delius?
Yes. That was taken a long time ago.
Your bedroom is through here. I hope that you will be comfortable. I will tell Delius that you have arrived, and I'll call you when he is ready.
The atmosphere of the place was somehow sinister, and I felt ill at ease. What was I doing here? Why had I come? I was playing chess one night with my father when Mother turned on the wireless for the news. There was music. But what music? I listened spellbound, and later heard the announcer say it was by Frederick Delius. It Later, I read articles on Delius and his music, and learnt that he was now blind and paralyzed and unable to work anymore. Apparently, there were several works which he'd begun and been unable to complete. He could bear with his misfortune if only he could finish these scores. I remember how I walked for miles on the cliffs, reflecting on the helplessness of the man. What delicacy of feeling was in his music? What must such a sensitive nature be suffering? Couldn't anything be done? Of course I'd be willing to. But how dare I presume such a thing? It was preposterous. I dismissed the idea. During the next few weeks, the conceit that I could help became an obsession. It was always there, and in the end I couldn't sleep for it. Finally, it conquered me, and getting up in the middle of the night, I wrote to Delius, offering my help for 3 or 4 years. I'd do anything to be the means of his finishing that music. How it was going to be done? Well, God alone knew the answer to that. I told no one, and waited anxiously for his reply. It came in the handwriting of his wife.
Dear Mr. Fenby, I'm greatly touched by your kind and sympathetic letter, and should love to accept your offer. Come here by all means as soon as you can and see if you like it. This is a lovely spot. Just a quiet little village, and our house is in a big garden close to the river. But of course, we live very much alone, and you will no doubt...
Delius is waiting downstairs for you.
Thank you.
Here is Mr. Fenby.
Come in, Fenby. I'm very glad to meet you.
Well, sir, this is a great honor. I'm very proud and privileged to come here, and it's very good of you to receive me so kindly.
Did you have a pleasant journey?
Very pleasant, thank you, sir.
Now, Fenby, make yourself at home. Use everything in your part of the house as if it were your own. My music room. Oh, but tell me about yourself. Tell me a little about your musical activities in Scarborough.
Well, lately, sir, I've earned my living as relief organist at the Futurist Cinema, improvising to the films. Mostly Laurel and Hardy's.
Laurel and Hardy's?
Yes, sir. They're comics.
I'm here. Pauline is here.
Einmal, bitte.
Genug.
I knew Scarborough when I was a boy. We used to live at Bradford. Do you know it? A filthy place, full of factories. My father owned one. Wool. I got away from it as often as I possibly could. In the holidays, we used to take a house on the coast at Filey. I nearly got drowned on the brig once. But I used to go over to Scarborough for the cricket festivals and sit on the popular bank with a bottle of ginger pop and my sandwiches watching the play. Do they still have that German band on the spar?
Oh, no, they've got a fine symphony orchestra. We actually have English music there now.
English music? Did you say English music? What's that? I've never heard of any. Geben Sie mir mein Bier.
I hope you like spinach. We grow all our own vegetables here. But I look after the flowers. They are my great joy.
Lesen Sie.
Edgar Wallace?
Ja, ja, ja. Schnell, schnell, schnell.
In Australien nannte man ihn nur den nervösen Drache. Er gab sich immer besonders feige und schuchtern. In Scotland Yard traf erst vor kurzem eine genaue Beschreibung ein. Und wir begannen, Sussex nach einem Mann abzusuchen, der...
Bruder, carry me away.